Okay, so in this video, we'll be talking about technical drawings and plans. Okay, so first we will define what is a blueprint. Okay, so a blueprint is a type of paper-based production, usually of a technical drawing, documenting an architecture or an engineering design. More generally, the term blueprint has to come to be used to refer to any detailed plan. So a blueprint is a copy of the original document or technical drawing which is made by the architect or the engineer. So because it is just a copy, it will also show the detailed plan in which it is similar to the original. Okay. Then we have the types of construction plans. So if you are going to have construction works, so we need to have also the plans. Each part of a building will have its own plan, especially each type of work that we are going to do. We must have also a plan for that or a detailed drawing for that. So first we have the zoning and the site plan. It will contain the perspective view of the whole building, the lot plan, and the location map. Then we have the architectural plan. It will contain the architectural details, including the elevation plans, the window and the door profiles, the roof plan, and others. Then the structural plan will contain the structural details of the building, including the beam details, walling details, truss and roof framework, and the computation of supports and footings. Then we have electrical plan. So it contains the details of all electrical devices, wirings, and their locations. Also contains the competition of the conductors and the overcurrent protection. And the last one will be the sanitary and plumbing plan, which contains the details of the piping for the plumbing works, the septic tank details, and the computation and the waste water management plan. Okay, so this will be the example of a lot plan, the lot and zoning plan, site development plan, zoning and site development plan. So this, as you can see, it will contain the perspective of the house or the actual appearance if the house or if the project will be finished. Then we have the lot plan, which also details the markers, the lot markers, and also the adjacent lot to the proposed site. Then we have the technical specification. So usually this is done by a surveyor. Then we have the location map. It will detail where will be the actual site, with respect to the roads and the direction bearing here. Okay. Then we have the architectural plan, which contain the front and rear elevation, the right side elevation and the left side elevation, the longitudinal section and the cross section. We have the ceiling plan and the roof plan. Then also the floor plan. Then you have the window and the door details, then the restroom and the restroom section plan. Okay. Then next we have the structural plan. It contains the foundation plan, the roof deck framing plan, the this is the beam schedule. Then we have the footing and the tie beam detail, then we have the column. Then we have the footing schedule here. Then you have the details of the truss, then the truss schedule of members, then we have the connection detail for the trusses and the roof beam details. Then next we have the electrical plan. It will have the electrical layout. So for this one, it contains both the power and the lighting layout. You have the one line diagram, the legends and the symbols, the load schedule, then we have the location map, then the panel details, then we have the general notes and specifications. It will contain the standards in which the installer must follow for this installation, electrical installation. Then the last one, we have the plumbing and sanitary plan. So this is the plumbing layout. So this is the isometric view showing the elevation of the plumbing pipes, and these are the septic tank details, the section details and the manhole details. Then we have here the symbols used for the piping and this, and also the symbols used for the details of the septic tank. And for this one is the computation for the size of the pipes and the size of the septic tank. Okay, so I believe that will be all for this video. I hope you understand something. And as always, enjoy learning.